Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. SubhanAllah, this month is a month seeking the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should know that the period between one Ramadan to the next, all those sins that you have committed and accumulated, subhanAllah, where we have wronged ourselves and transgressed, these can be forgiven. We've just got to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have a fresh start. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. When my servants ask you about me, Ya Rasulullah, of course I am near. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. I respond to the caller of the one who calls whenever he calls. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. So that they should respond to me. They should have some kind of yearning. We should have some kind of want and hope that we turn towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe in Him so that we may be on the right path. In a hadith, in a beautiful hadith in Muslim, As-salatu khams wa jum'a ila jum'a wa ramadan ila ramadan mukaffirat ma baynahunna majtunibat al-kabair. The time between the five prayers, two consecutive five prayers, two consecutive Ramadan are expiation for all that has happened during the period, provided that one has avoided major sins. And of course, we know the beautiful hadith that whoever observes fast during the month of Ramadan out of sincere faith and hoping to attain Allah's reward, then all his sins are going to be forgiven. You know, we've got to realize this is an opportunity. Allah is looking for an excuse to forgive all our sins. Why not have that positive start, have that conviction, knowing that Allah is the Ghaffar and Allah will forgive your sins. Jazakallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.